Evie, how good is it feel to finally have that gold medal around your neck?
I mean, it feels amazing. I think that there were so many, like, the best junior girls in the world were here. And just being able to put down a good run feels so great.
And you're now a world champion. I know you've been itching to become a world champion for forever. Feels like forever, but only a couple of years. But you are now a world champion.
I mean, it's just crazy. It's definitely something that I've been dreaming of for a really long time, and I knew that I wanted to come here before the games. You know, no matter what happened, I knew that it was going to be a really good feeling. I just have so much fun out here competing at the Junior Worlds, but to come back with a medal is just so exciting.
So just talk us through that, Evie, because all the other athletes have gone to Tokyo. You chose to stay here and to do the juniors. What was your thinking behind that? Why did you do that?
So I'm deep into like Tokyo preparation mode. I think that every other athlete's already there for the pre-games training camp, but Junior Worlds has always been the future goal of mine. It's always been kind of like Junior Worlds and the Olympics. And I know that I only get one more Junior Worlds, and I really wanted to kind of make it count and go to one while I still could. And I think that just like having this good feeling on the water is going to help me so much in Tokyo mentally. You know, it'd be really hard to be in Tokyo watching this and missing it. So I'm really happy to be a part of this and looking so forward to going to Tokyo.
And it's a good point, because if you had have missed this and gone straight from the last two World Cups, which by your standards weren't the best results, but now you've come here and won a gold medal and become world champion, it must have made a big difference to your confidence.
Definitely, definitely. I haven't made a final yet this year until now. So the World Cups, I got 11th in Markkleeberg, you know, so close, but not quite there. So to kind of have the results that I wanted here, it's just mentally so good for me for Tokyo.
And now you can start thinking about the Olympics.
Yeah, I don't think it's really hit me yet. I don't think it'll hit me till I'm there. You know, it's kind of crazy that I'm going to the Olympics, but like I said, it just hasn't hit me yet, so I'm super excited to land.
You're going to be our youngest competitor there, 17 years of age, at the Olympics. I mean, just to be there is awesome, isn't it? But to go there now as a junior world champion and the youngest competitor there, I mean, so many great things you're taking to Tokyo already.
I mean, it's just, you know, no matter what happens, it's going to be such an incredible experience, you know, to be there with the top paddlers in the entire world, and, you know, the top athletes in the entire world, and kind of getting to be, just getting to be near that, getting to be, like, in that excitement of everyone wanting to do their best is going to, like, propel me. I'm just so excited.
And Evie, just a final question. We know now that there aren't going to be crowds there, which obviously will be a little bit disappointing for athletes and for everybody, but I suppose just to be at the Olympics is the big thing, isn't it?
I mean, I'm going to Tokyo with not that many expectations. You know, I think a lot of athletes there, they've already been to a Games and they know what to expect. I've never been to a Games. I have no idea what to expect. So no matter what,
ladies and gentlemen, the medal ceremony of the 2021 ICF Men's Slalom Junior and the 23 World Championships from Yana Thompson will begin.
I'm going to try and soak it up as much as possible, spectators or no spectators.
Well, congratulations, Evie. You'll go there as a world champion, which is fantastic. We're looking forward to seeing you in Tokyo. But first and foremost, we really enjoyed your run today. It was something special. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.